Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today, let's talk about sheets and tables in Mac Numbers. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 1,000 supporters. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you can read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So when you want to get beyond the very basics in Numbers, you want to understand how sheets and tables work. Let's create a blank Numbers document here. And what it's going to do for us is create a default sheet and in there a default table. So let's back up a bit. A Numbers file is simply called a document. It's the same for most things on the Mac. A Pages document, a Keynote document, and you have a Numbers document. If you're used to using Microsoft Excel, then a file is also called a document, but it's also commonly called a workbook. You don't really call Numbers documents workbooks. You just call them documents. Now inside each document you have one or more sheets. Now you may never get beyond using a single sheet in a document. In this case you can see here I just have one sheet. If you only ever use one sheet you may not even notice sheet one here at the top. And it's okay just to leave it like that, but there's a lot you can do with sheets. Like for instance you can add another one. So here I've added sheet two and I could switch between them. They almost seem like they're separate documents, but they're actually two sheets in the same document. Microsoft Excel does the same thing and they actually call them sheets there as well, although an older term for that is worksheet. Now with sheets you can do a lot here by clicking on the little down arrow to bring up a pop-up menu. Here you can rename the sheet, you can duplicate it, you can show sheet options which will bring up format sheet in the sidebar. You can do the same thing by selecting the background here. I'll select the background, deselecting the table, and you can see under format there's only sheet here. And there's another way here to change the name. You could also just double click here to change the name for any sheet. Note you could set a background color for a sheet. So if it helps you to differentiate the sheets, maybe make it easier to move between them and remember which one you're in, you can use a color. It will help of course if you set it to be a very subtle color. So for instance something that's really close to white but maybe tinted. You can also cut, copy, and paste sheets if you like, and of course delete them. You can also rearrange the order that they're in by dragging them back and forth. Now each sheet is like a blank sheet of paper. It always starts off with a default table. So I got this one in the original sheet. Any others I create give me a smaller default table. But I could easily select the table by clicking the little circle here at the top left, delete it, and there's nothing on the sheet at all. It's a blank sheet of paper. You can add lots of things to sheets. For instance, in addition to tables, I could also add a chart. I could add some text, and it's just a text box. And I can move it around, and I can make the text larger, style it. I could add a shape. There are a variety of different shapes. You can use anything that you use in Pages or Keynote. You can also do arrows, connecting lines, all sorts of things. You can even add media like photos. You can even put videos and audio on a sheet as well. So you can do all the basics that you can do in Pages and Keynote here inside of a sheet in Numbers. In fact, we can see some of this in use if we just use one of the existing templates. Here's a home improvement template and you can see here there are some images here at the top. There's some text boxes. There's a line here. And then you've got a table and a couple of charts. And notice in this template it uses multiple sheets. You've got a sheet for costs, products, a to-do list sheet, and a contact list sheet. Here's another template that's for just storing recipes. And in this one you can see there's a picture here, there's some text, a line, and there are a few different tables. And this here is just some text. Here's an example of a document that just has a single sheet in it. It doesn't need additional ones. But it does have multiple tables. So to create a new table all you need to do is click Table here, choose one of these starting points, and it will insert it in. In this case I've already added two tables here and I've moved them around, put them however you want on the sheet. And this is a very simple document here. I don't want to put these on separate sheets. I just put two tables next to each other. Now note that the use of tables is one of the biggest differentiators between Numbers and Excel. In Excel you have a single table in each sheet. It goes all the way from the top left to the bottom right. It's just filled with cells inside of a single table. But in Numbers, you can have multiple tables inside of a sheet. Now one of the things that's confusing then is how do you refer to cells from table to table? But you don't really have to think about it too much because Numbers makes it easy. Let's create an extra table here. And let's say I wanted to have two numbers and I wanted to add them together. I'll type equals for formula. And I could simply do A1 plus B1 and I'll get the result. Takes cell A1 and cell B1, adds them together. Now how would I do that if it's in another table? After all, if I want to refer to cell A1 here, it's different than this A1. Well, you could type it all out, but there's no need to because you can simply click to select a cell. So let's just do the same formula again. I'll do equals and I'll click here to select A1 plus and click here to select B1. I get the same result. But what if I were to do equals, click here, plus, and then click here? It's going to go and figure out what to put there so it refers to that cell. In this case, since the row and column are unique, it's simply going to use those. Instead of B2, it's going to say amount, atom. If there was another table that also had amount and atom, then you would see it say contributions, amount, atom. Each table has a name just like a sheet does. So this new table here has this name here at the top. I can change this to whatever I want. And that's the name or title of that table. You can actually go to Format Table and hide the title, but that's the only way for you to actually name the table. So even though it's hidden, the name of the table is still there. You can reveal it, change it to whatever you want, and then turn it off again if you really don't want to see the name. But the general idea is that clicking to add a cell to a formula is the best way to make sure you're selecting the right cell. So when using multiple tables, forget about typing in things like A1 and simply click on the cell that you want to use. So for instance here we've got trip expenses and a total and contributions and a total. Let's say we want to calculate the outstanding amount, the amount that is still owed. We can add another row here. And we can call that outstanding. And then to do the calculation here, I would do equals and this, the total expenses, minus the total contributions. And it will correctly calculate the result, taking the values from two different tables. Another way to do this would be simply to create another table. There's nothing wrong with having tables that are very small. So I can create a table like this. I can shrink it down to where there's just one value. In fact, I can even get rid of the header row there. Just have this one value here and I'll do equals and I'll say expenses minus contributions. There's the total. I'll call this table outstanding. And now I can have this as a single cell table that I move around and place wherever I want. Now here's an example of a document that uses multiple sheets. In this case I'm recording daily sales and I want sales totals. Now the daily sales is going to be a table that's going to grow and grow and grow. So I probably don't want to combine that with other tables in the same sheet. So I have a sheet here just called sales. It's got one big table in it. That table is going to keep growing as I add more sales to it. If I put another table here, once this table grows very long, it's going to be hard to scroll all the way to the top here to see what information is in the smaller table. So just having one table and a sheet like Microsoft Excel does works for something like this where it's essentially a database of information. However, I also have another sheet here called daily sales. And here I've got dates and I have the total sales for that day. So the formula here is actually going to draw on values from a different sheet. And you could do that just as easily as getting values from a different table. Let's select this cell here and delete it so I can recreate it. I'm going to use SUMIF to get the total sales for the date here. So I'll do equals to start a formula. I'll do SUMIF and the column for the values is going to be here in the sales table. Notice I still have a floating formula right here. It hasn't gone away. So I'll select column B there and it adds it in. Then comma. Now the value is back here in the first sheet. It's this. This is the date for this row. Comma. Now the values come from here. So I'll select this one. And then I'll close the parenthesis and hit return. It's going to take me back here since I just entered a value for this cell. So this gives me the correct amount right there. And I could see here in the formula it's going to the sales sheet date. That's the column. And you can see here it's referring to sales date. But here it just says price. Why? Well, there's only one column in my entire document called price. So that's all it needs to show me so I know which column it's referring to. But there are two columns that are called date. There's this one and the column called date in the sales sheet in the table there. So it shows me sales and two colons date. So now it's very clear exactly where these values are coming from. And it gives me the correct amount right there, drawing on one value from this table and two columns from this table. So it's important if you're creating anything but the simplest numbers spreadsheets to understand sheets and tables and also to get a lot of use out of them. You can certainly go and have one table in one sheet and put different types of data in different cells and treat things like a single sheet in an Excel workbook. But you're not taking full advantage of what Numbers has to offer unless you're trying to break things up into multiple tables across multiple sheets to have a document that makes the most sense and that you can use efficiently. If you liked this video, click the thumbs up button below to let me know. I publish new tutorials each weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out.